So what happened to me was he invited me to his launch. This can't be happening. Like I can't, I don't even know what to think at the time. And he asked me to sit on his bed and he kissed me in my mouth. And then he put his hand into my shirt.
Enough. Don't cry.
After he finished, I went out. Most shocking thing was there was a girl waiting outside the door to go inside. He turned around, he told me, "What did I tell you about having a good night?" This is one of the double meaning thing that he told me.
And when you came to know that he got arrested, what was your reaction then?
It was a very happy day for me when I got to know that he got arrested.
வணக்கம். சுஷில் ஹரி இன்டர்நேஷனல் ஸ்கூல் சிவசங்கர் பாபாவால் பாதிக்கப்பட்ட எத்தனையோ மாணவிகள், எத்தனையோ மாணவர்கள் வெளிவந்து எங்களுடன் தன்னுடைய கதைகளை பகிர்ந்து கொண்டிருக்கிறார்கள். இந்த பெண்கள் எந்த அளவில் பாதிக்கப்பட்டிருக்கிறார்கள் என்று இவர்கள் வாயாலேயே நீங்கள் கேட்டுக்கொண்டிருக்கிறீர்கள். அதே பாணியில் மலேசியாவை சார்ந்த ஒரு மாணவி, இந்த மாணவியும் இதே சுஷில் ஹரி இன்டர்நேஷனல் ஸ்கூலில் ஒரு வருடம் வரை படித்திருக்கிறார். இந்த பெண்ணுடனும் இதே சிவசங்கர் பாபா தவறான முறையில் நடந்து கொண்டிருக்கிறார். எப்படி என்ன நடந்ததென்ற அந்த அனைத்து விஷயத்தையுமே இந்த பெண்மணி தன் வாயாலேயே கூற இருக்கிறார். இவரை கேட்கலாம், பாருங்கள். ஹலோ.
ஹாய்.
ஹாய். For how many years you were there in the school?
So I was there from 2007 to 2008.
Okay. And how was the experience in the school?
It's for me, the school is actually a very good school. The teachers are really good. It's just that one experience has actually for me has tarnished the whole school's name, and I will never personally go back to the school again because what I went through there.
Okay, the school is nice, the teachers are nice, but that experience made you to, go out from the school, and you will never go back to that school again. Yeah.
I will never go back to the school again.
Okay.
So what happened exactly?
So, to first of all, I got to know about this issue through a friend of mine. She's a very close friend of mine. Before that, I've never heard of this happening. So when she came to me, she told me that he touched her. I didn't believe her. So I just thought I wasn't sure why was she saying that about him. So I just ignored what she said. And only after it happened to me that I actually believed and knew that what she was saying was the truth. So what happened to me was he invited me to his launch. As usual, I didn't expect anything to happen. Probably it was just to discuss something or anything. We at that moment, because we have regarded him as God, as someone we look up to, and as a father,
A fatherly figure.
I lost my father at a very young age, so that's why when he came and when he showed so much of care towards us, you kind of get totally attached to that kind of person. So when he invited me there, I didn't even think anything was going to happen. I just thought, okay. And at that time, when I was in the school, every time he looked at us, every time he waved at us, every time he spoke to us or smiled to us, that was like such a great thing that happened to you. Like it is such a like you just feel so blessed and so happy about it. So when he personally called you to his launch, it is like a blessing. Like, oh my God, he's calling me, let's go. And so when he called me there, I went in and there was this lady. She is Bharati's mother. She was in the hall. She was cleaning the hall. So we had a chit chat in the hall area. And then I can't remember what we spoke about, but then after that we went to, he said there is a temple. So there's a temple just next to the hall, and crossing the, after you pass the temple, you will go to his bedroom. So he said to me, go and wash your hands and leg and go and pray in the little temple that he had. So like that, I just went and pray. And as I was doing so, he closed the door behind me. And I didn't.
He was all alone there.
No, so the lady was there the whole time. Even when he called me in the room, Baladi's mother was there.
Okay.
So that's why when I was so confused, because this lady is there, she's a lady, and I'm a girl. I still wasn't sure when he closed the door. I still wasn't sure what's happening. I was thinking, this can't be happening. Like I can't. I don't even know what to think at the time. So after that, he said, "Okay, go to the bathroom in his room." He said, "Go to the bathroom, go and gargle your mouth with the mouth freshener in there." So I did so, and I came, and he asked me to sit on his bed, and he kissed me in my mouth, and then he put his hand into my shirt, and then he was saying that, like, I'm doing this because I can foresee something.
Enough. Don't cry. And enough, you explained. I don't want, you know. Just drink some water. Few words have spoken a lot, you know. Just drink some water, please. Please drink some water. You know, don't explain further. I can understand what you have gone through, and I can totally understand. You don't need to explain anything further. This is enough.
So basic, I just want to let you know that how he made me just stay there is because he was saying, like, I'm doing this because I foresee a disease that is going to come upon you. So I'm trying to, before it happened, I'm trying to do this to cure you. So I didn't, I don't know if I should believe what he said, but at that time, you just in the shock, and whatever he's saying is just you can't do anything at the moment because you're alone, and you know how powerful this man is because he's saying that, like, he's the amount of influence he have in the society, the lawyers, the doctors, everyone that he know. You were thinking, like, oh, what is, how am I going to come out from this? How am I going to voice out? Because will people believe me? Or will he get pay people to shut you up, or pay people to put the case back on you, kind of thing?
Okay, this happened in front of that lady.
No, so the lady was in the hall, so
Okay.
she brought me into the room,
Okay.
and when I after he finished, I went out. Most shocking thing was there was a girl waiting outside the door to go inside. And when I saw her, I was in shock as well. I was like, because I didn't want people to know that this happened to me. I because it's very embarrassing that to know, let people know that this has happened to me. So when I saw her, I was in shock. So I can't remember what I said to her, maybe like hi or something. But as soon as she smelled that mouth refreshener from my mouth as I was speaking to her, she understood what happened inside, and she was just smiling towards me, and she just, like, she was in a happy gesture, like, oh, this has happened to you as well, kind of thing. And she went inside. So I knew that that wasn't the first time that has happened to her, and then it I kind of realized that this is something that is ongoing here.
Okay. After the incident, for how long you were there in that school? Did you took TC immediately, or it took some time?
It took some time. I was there. I think this happened in the first 6 months of me being there. I completed the year. So I stayed for another 6 months, and then I finished after I left after I finished year 11.
Did you narrate this thing to your friends? Did you complain to your mother? Anyone, even the school? Nobody.
No. First of all, my mother, she's a single mother. She have brought me up so difficultly. It was through her that someone that she know that she sent me to this school. So I didn't want to upset her. I didn't want to hurt her. And I didn't say that to anybody, not even to teachers, because we know everyone speaks so highly about him. And we know anyone who goes against him will be insulted in public during the satsang. So it's more of, we were scared. I was scared to voice out, or I wasn't sure who I can trust, who will actually believe what I'm going to say.
Okay. After that, did this person, invited you again, or, you met him in person? Did anything further happen?
No, it was just that one experience. And after that, I was very... I kept my distance away from him because I didn't want this to happen. I was very sure I don't want to go through that again. So I keep my distance away from him. I wasn't very close to him after that.
Did any one of your friend who came up to you and they would have told you, okay, this is what happened, or did someone try to influence you? If Baba calls you to his lounge, you should go. He will bless you. Something like that.
Thankfully, that didn't happen to me. No one influenced me. It was just this independent incident that happened to me.
Okay. When you took TC, did you got the TC easily, or he tried to stop you or something?
No, I did get the TC easily. He did highly recommend. Like, they did give a very good recommendation, because I was joining a school in Melbourne. So we needed a recommendation from the school. So they did give me a very good recommendation letter.
So when you joined the school and when you met the Baba first time, what was your impression then?
So I didn't know that there was such person in this school. I was just told that it's a very good international school, and that because we are coming from abroad, everything is included in the school, so we don't need to go out or anything like that. So it's a whole environment, a good environment kind of thing. So I can't remember what day, but he came like on his morning walk in our hostel, around our hostel. So everyone started hugging him. So that was the first thing. Like, I was surprised because like I said, I lost my father at a very young age. So I've never seen people hugging, just like a stranger kind of thing, a man, especially an elder man like that. So all these girls will go up and hug him. So then I understood that is a tradition here. And then that's what you should do. So, that was when I first saw him, and my first impression was, this is what you have to do.
See, my question is, in his satsangs, he used to often crack double meaning jokes, right? And most of it would be in Tamil, right? So did he make some jokes in English, or did he try to talk in double meaning with you ever before the incident happened?
So I do understand Tamil. My mom is Indian. So, but the thing is, I don't practice speaking it. So the way I speak, it's a very funny way, like a white person trying to speak Tamil. So that's why I don't speak unless...
Okay, your dad is Malaysian and your mom is Indian.
So dad is Chinese, Malaysian Chinese. Okay. Mom is Malaysian Indian. They were born and brought up in Malaysia.
Okay.
So to your question, so he does tell me some kind of... he does say double meaning jokes, and I have this habit of writing my diary on a daily basis. And when this issue came up, I actually found one of my diary that I was having and writing when I was in the school. And it to my, I was so shocked that I have read this in my diary. I've written this down in my diary. It was like, he said, so it was one night that I wished him good night, and he told me, how can it be a good night if you are going back to your place and I'm going back to my place? And then as I walked him back to his lodge, he said, before he entered his door, he turned around, he told me, what did I tell you about having a good night? This is one of the double meaning thing that he told me. And at that moment, I don't think I understand what he was trying to say, but I wrote it down in my diary. And now reading it back, it actually gives me a lot of chill, because I'm like, I don't understand how I didn't understood it then, and it was like a warning, but I didn't take that warning.
Okay, that was a warning which you didn't took up. Okay, now you're listening to all these stories, many many people like you, girls like you, who are coming up and telling us, recording their statements. And when you came to know that he got arrested, what was your reaction there?
I actually got to know from this girl. I told you earlier, the girl who told me that he touched her. So I came to know from this girl, and she messaged me and she said to me, "Did you hear about what happened?" I said no, and she's like, "He got arrested. People are putting allegation on him that he touched them, the girls." And she said, "It's so sad." So I asked her, "What do you mean so sad? Because he have touched you before, and I don't know what, because I, first of all, she's married and she has kids and she still worship him and the whole family worship him as well. So I think she has put this incident, hidden this incident away from the family, and also she has just put it aside. So when I told her, this has happened to you as well, you are the one who told me, and she's like, oh yes, it has happened to me. I forgot that it happened to me. But that's what she told me.
So that much of blind faith, or that much of blind faith all these people have on him, right?
Yes. So when it happened, when she said that he was arrested, and then I can't confirm this with another friend as well. And I was just happy, because I never ever thought that this would happen, this day would come, because I so badly want it to happen, but I didn't know that it would happen. I didn't know that it will one day come. So it was just it was a very happy day for me, that when I got to know that he got arrested.
Is that possible that if someone from CBCID who are investigating on this issue, and if they contact you, will you be able to give your statement? Are you ready to record your statement to police?
Yes.
Yeah, great, great, great. So, okay, what sort of punishment you are looking at he should get?
I just want him to be behind bars for the rest of his life. And I just don't want this thing to happen to another girl. That is all that I ask for. So he shouldn't be let out at all.
I wish people like you should come up. You're such a brave and wonderful human. And whatever happened to you, I don't want, in my dream also, I don't want anyone should go through what you have gone through. Your tears spoke everything. You shouldn't, more than you, your expressions, the way you told, it's all explained. So I wish if you can write the same thing to the investigating team after this call. I will send you their email address and contact number, and it'll be a great support from your end. Like if your statement is registered, recorded officially to the CBCID police and their investigation, and may God give you all power to come up. I'm sure you have moved on, And but yes, your statements will save a lot more lives, a lot more, you know, girls in
Yeah,
the future.
definitely.
You know, I wish
Yes,
this thing
definitely.
happened.
Thank you.
So, மலேசியாவை சார்ந்த இந்த பெண்மணி பேசிய ஒவ்வொரு வார்த்தையும் நீங்கள் கேட்டீர்கள். இந்த பெண்ணுடைய கண்ணீர் மொத்த விஷயத்தையுமே கூறிவிட்டது. இந்த பெண் பேசக்கூட முடியாமல் தன் கண்ணீராலேயே பல விஷயங்களை எடுத்து காட்டிவிட்டாள். இது போன்ற எத்தனை பெண்கள் இன்னும் இருப்பார்கள் என்று எனக்கு தெரியவில்லை. ஒவ்வொரு நாளும் இதே போன்ற பெண்கள், ஒவ்வொரு நாளும் இதே போன்ற கதைகள் தான் எங்களுக்கு முன் வருகிறது. வாட்ஸ்அப் வழியாக, இமெயில் வழியாக அல்ல, ஜூம் டெலிஃபோன் வழியாக. இன்னும் எத்தனை பெண்கள் இருப்பார்கள் என்று கூட எங்களுக்கு தெரியவில்லை. ஆனால் கூட கடைசியாக இன்னொரு முறை அதே கோரிக்கை, இதே போன்று நீங்களும் பாதிக்கப்பட்ட நபராக இருந்தால் தயவு செய்து கீழே எழுதியிருக்கும் இந்த இமெயில் அட்ரஸ், டெலிஃபோன் நம்பருக்கு தொடர்பு கொண்டு சிபிசிஐடிக்கு முன், இன்வெஸ்டிகேட்டிங் இந்த ஏஜென்சிக்கு முன் உங்களுடைய கதையை எடுத்து கூறுவீர்கள் என்று நம்புகிறேன். எங்களுடைய டெலிஃபோன் நம்பர், எங்களுடைய இமெயில் அட்ரஸும் கீழே கொடுத்துருக்கோம். அப்படி எங்களுடன் தொடர்பு கொள்ள நினைக்கும் நபர்கள் நேரடியாக எங்களுக்கும் எழுதலாம், தொடர்பு கொள்ளலாம். இதை நீங்கள் செய்வீர்கள் என்று நம்பி விடைபெறுகிறேன். நன்றி, வணக்கம்.